Hello students, so we are going to do this subject test number 5. We will discuss the methods by which you can do any question. So we are starting with question number 1. These two compounds are in the liquid phase at room temperature. So when it is written at room temperature, then there are just actually this should be two elements, not compounds but elements. So the two elements which are in the liquid phase at room temperature will be bromine. Bromine is a liquid non-metal, and mercury is a liquid metal. Because otherwise if you take compounds, there are so many compounds which are in the liquid phase at room temperature, but this is elements. So one is bromine and second is mercury. These two compounds have colorful ionic solutions in water. So answer will be iron and cobalt. Iron and cobalt compounds will be like if we take ferrous sulfate, that is greenish in color, so ferric will be brown. So ferric and cobalt salts, they will be colorful ionic solutions having some color. Cobalt compounds will be blue. These two compounds are allotropes of each other. Allotropes. Allotropes is the property of an element again. Existence of an element in more than one form with the same chemical properties but different physical properties. So this is diamond and graphite. Diamond and graphite are nothing but two allotropic forms of carbon. So allotropy is always the property of an element. So when this is existence of an element in more than one form with the same chemical properties but different physical. One of the allotropic form of carbon is charcoal also, lamp black, coke. But just see the difference between diamond and charcoal. So they are physically so different, but chemically they are same, consisting of only carbon, nothing else. These two compounds are good oxidizing agents. So fluorine and chlorine, they are good oxidizing agents. And as we move down, iodine is a good reducing agent. So oxidizing agent means it will oxidize others, but itself it will be getting reduced into F minus. So this is getting reduced, but F fluorine molecule will first break up into atoms and which can act as a oxidizing agent. Now if you see this diagram, activation energy diagram, so you are given this. A is from here to here A, B is this, C will be this one up till this point, C to B, so we will see, it's the activation energy of forward reaction. Activation energy of forward reaction will be, answer will be C. Actually if you see, this is the activation energy of forward reaction. Because here you have reactants and here you have products. So this diagram is of endothermic reaction. How can you say it is endo? Because the energy of products is more than energy of reactants. So in endothermic reaction, enthalpy of products will be more than enthalpy of reactants. And delta H is always enthalpy of product minus of reactant. So in an endothermic reaction, delta H will be positive. But if you take exothermic reaction, in an exothermic reaction heat is given out, heat is released, so enthalpy of products will be smaller than enthalpy of reactants and delta H will become negative for exo. So this I have shown you, this is C only, na C, activation energy of the forward reaction will be C from here to here.